Yo, what is up, guys? MattWic here, and we are back with another NHL 18 video. This one's going to be a little bit different. We are in our NHL 18 GM mode test draft. So the one we've been putting up with all the entry drafts, and this is just going to be, we're going to go back and look through each team's roster, go through their main roster and the people in their system, and just see how everybody's been developing. We're in the year, I think this is the start of the 2024 season. So we're going to take a look at this here, or 2023, 2024, I believe. I'm not sure. But let's take a look. This is what Anaheim looks like. If you really tell, their roster is getting pretty old. Let's go in the system, see what they've got. They've got no really prospects either. So, wow, they're going to be struggling for a couple years. They got a couple guys here who are look like they're getting ready to come up. Maxim Comtos, who they took in 2017, is still 75 overall. So nobody really developing for them. They're someone to look out for to struggle in the future years. Arizona looks like this. Dylan Strome and Jacob Churchin. Actually, let's do this. There we go. We sorted. Now let's go back to Anaheim. There they go. So they have one guy who's looking pretty good. Boris Korpostev. Medium elite, 21 years old. Drafted in the third round. Wow, he's now an 81 overall at 21. Let's go in the system now and see. There they go. They've got Vegeta. He is growing. He's in his hyper chamber or whatever that was called that he has. They're over at his, fuck man, I can't even watch, I haven't watched Dragon Ball in like 3 days and I forget everything about it. Capsule Corp, he's over with his waifu, and he's training to become a better hockey player. So there we go, let's go main roster, let's go back, let's go Arizona Coyotes, Churchin, Clayton Keller, and Dylan Strome, looking good there. They've developed very nicely. They won a Stanley Cup, I believe, in this GM mode. There's their prospects there. They don't really have anybody too special, no elites to look at. Guys, maybe one guy, two guys down here trying to crack the roster in the next couple of years. Let's go to Boston. Charlie McAvoy, 89 overall, guys becoming a stud. Cody Toms, guy they drafted in 2021 with the first overall pick. He's only 1981 overall right now. Let's go look at in the system. No real elite prospects in there. They got a couple guys, and I was looking at this just while I was going through, just doing some pre-scouting for the video, and I would hate to have this team. All these names, you guys make fun of me in the comments just for how I pronounce some of these guys' names, but Jesus Christ, if I had a team like this, maybe that's a GM mode I'll have to do, just draft guys with names that I can't pronounce. Buffalo, let's see, Jack Eichel is a stud. Ruski, 91 overall, high elite, 26 years old, so he's pretty much done developing. And then they have this guy, Joel Mikias, 2023 first round pick with the fifth. He's developed already, 81 overall, 18 years old. Can't wait till I can get a guy like that in one of my GMs. And then they have Wonton Soup here, Mr. Curtis Wonton Soup, low elite, 19 years old. Drafted in 2022, third round. Wow, 19 years old and he's already 71. I'd like one of my guys to develop like he has. Let's go to Calgary now. They have a couple players here. Guy Brulette, third round pick. Wow, 82 overall now. Medium elite. Guy is a stud. He's got hella good skating and physical stats for being an offensive. Or he's actually defensive. Okay. There's actually, I think I was going through and I found another defensive defenseman who was drafted late who had just crazy skating, but horrible shooting. We'll maybe try to find him. Actually, is this him? No, I don't think this is him. Jacques Picard, 75 overall. He looks like he's going to get ready to go in the NHL soon. And Matthew Tkachuk. All right, let's go in the system. Check out what they got. They have no elites here, but they have a couple guys maybe who look to crack in the NHL roster coming up soon. Well, let's go back to the main roster, and then we'll go back through goalies, and we'll see how they're doing as well. Noah Hanifin, the Beanster, and Gauthier leading the way for Carolina. Noah Hanifin looks like a great, great player. Bean struggling to develop a little bit there as a low elite. Maybe go in and change his value a little bit just because these low elites look like they're really having a tough time developing, which, I mean, it's nice because they're not going to ruin the game with how many are in the draft, but it's kind of disappointing because these guys are really, everybody's kind of struggling to develop at the moment. So we'll see whenever some players start retiring and more of these creative players get in and see what the rosters look like as well. Appel there, 19 years old. Caesar, fourth round pick here for Carolina. And Dave Visakas, yeah. Third round pick in 2019. He's developing nicely. Low elite, 22 years old, 74 overall. So that's not bad. Let's go back to the main roster. Next team, Chicago. And I was actually struggling to see this. I want to see, do they not have... Okay, He's a medium, exact top nine now, Jonathan Toews. I didn't see him there before, and I was wondering if he was even still on the team. But they have Kyle Fitzmaurice, who was drafted first round, third pick. He's developing nicely. Jack Nash, 2018 draft, very early one. Fifth round pick, low elite, 23 years old, 80 overall, very nice for him. Let's check in the system. Shirokov and Shishkinov. A couple of nice combination there for them. Shirokov, let's see what he's 6'5". Wow, big guy. Third round, he was drafted medium elite. Now let's take him off at Stanislav. Shishkinov, defensive defenseman. This guy looks pretty good. 74 overall, so maybe he'll get a little bit better and develop as well. Let's go back to the main roster. Let's go on to the next team, Colorado. Tyler Joust, Rantanen, and Valeno. This guy, if you have a chance to draft him in your draft, definitely take him. He's only 23 years old, and he is a stud. Look at that, 87 overall, and take him with the second pick. So you have a chance to go after him. Definitely, definitely do it. Do not pass on him. Try to trade up for him in your other GM modes. In the system, this is what it looks like. Nobody really special here. So let's just move on to the next team, which is Columbus. Werenski and Dubois developing nicely. This guy here, who they drafted in fifth round, Pavel Lanov, low top six guy. He's ready to crack the NHL lineup. He's ready as a top, fourth line guy. In the system, nobody really to speak of here. They have a couple guys who might be ready to crack the lineup in a year or two, but nothing other than that. Let's go to the Dallas Stars. McLaren, Hishkinen. I can't remember. Yeah, this guy was not taken. This guy was not drafted in the GM mode. He was actually taken in real life. 2017, he's developed nicely. He's a very good defenseman here. And then they have Bill McLaren, who this is, look at those stats. Holy shit, guys. Defensive defenseman, drafted in the second round, BU, 2019, 88 overall, medium elite, 99 acceleration, agility, and speed. If you watch Bacon Country, this guy is nine. He's fast. He is a burner. Senses are terrible, but everything else, this guy's a beast. Second round pick, too. If you go up against them and you look at their roster and you see this guy, you're like, how did I miss this guy? This is a guy you would love to have. Shot blocking and stick checking both at 99 as well. His physical stats are through the roof. His shot is disgusting. Wrist shot accuracy of 92 and his power of 94. This guy puts some rippers on the net. And then his puck skills are incredible as well. For a defensive defenseman, his stats are just unreal. So that's a good guy to look at. This guy right here, Denis Gurnov, 2015, so he wasn't taken. Let's go in the system. Nobody really here. They have one guy who might be ready to crack the lineup, Grant Perreault? Matthew Perreault? Yeah, I think it's after his name, so I'm going to go Grant Perreault. 2020, first round. He's got some decent stats. He's getting ready. He might be able to play in the NHL now, but I don't think they have him up, especially with a guy like Bill McLaren up there. Guy's a stud. Top four guy. 88 overall. Jeez, man, that's a heck of a pick. That's a steal right there. Let's go to the next team, Detroit Red Wings. They have been a team who have been drafting very well in this draft. They have George DiNicola, who they took second overall, who's a medium elite. 85 overall. Big guy, too. 6'5", 219. Next, they have Shane Higgins, who was taken fifth overall in 2020. 90 overall right now. So this guy has developed very, very, very well. He's got very good stats all the way around. Rated as the first line guy. Medium elite, only 21 years old, too, so he can develop. We'll have to follow his value, too. And then they have Tim Lepicito, low elite guy, 22 years old, taken in the second round 2019. So again, another defensive defenseman taken in 2019. That was a stud class, it looks like, with him and McLaren. So let's go in the system as well, see who they have. Strumbalumbalopoulos here taken. So he's going to develop nicely, probably medium elite, 18 years old, 70 overall now. Let's go on to the next team. But very good Detroit, very good drafting. Edmonton is literally stacked through the roof. McDavid, 94. Puljujarvi, 91. Draisaitl, 90. And Klefbom, 90 as well. And then you have Larson there as an 87. And then in the system, let's see what we've got. Nothing really crazy here. They have a couple low elites. Yurchina, who was drafted in 2019, seventh round, 75 overall. He's only 22, so that's a great pick there if he develops like he looks like he is. Let's go on to the next team, the Florida Panthers. They have a couple guys as well. They've drafted well. Medium elite here in 2022, yeah. First round, second overall, 85 overall. This guy's only 19, so he's got a lot of time to develop. Hopefully he keeps getting better. Ronnie Versey, he was taken in the first round as well with the fourth overall pick. He's an 82. And then our boy, who we have in our GM mode, hopefully he develops like this. Philip Zadina, who's taken third right behind Veleno. So let's see else in the system. Do they have anybody else? Rafalski, that's the only other guy, and he is a Gavin Rafalski defenseman, enforcer, 6'5", big dude. Undrafted, too, so they signed him as a free agent, so that's not a bad grab. Let's go main roster. Los Angeles, they have this guy, Ernest Stewart, taken 2023 first round, 79 overall, so he might be able to play in the NHL right away. They have a couple guys here rated as top six guys. Let's see, 2021 first round pick. So a couple first round picks. They've been drafting well. Guys are still in the system and developing for them. Let's go in the system now. They have Dwayne Black, Joshua Swift, and Greg Nightingale as their elite prospects. Guys, let's see. Dwayne Black looks like he's getting ready to crack in the NHL roster. He's ready as a third line guy now. Swift, low elite. He has to develop, and Nightingale, low elite, he is developing as well, 23 years old, so he's coming up on when he should be in the league. Minnesota Wild, Brodin, Edinburgher, no really elites on their squad. Let's go in the system. Low elite right there, 74 overall, so he's not bad. Fourth round in 2021, Jorgen Sunderstrom. So he looks like he might be able to develop. It's just trying to get these low elite guys. Wong, Adrian Wong, first round, 77 overall, it's not a bad pick. Let's see. Next, Montreal. They have Guerin, who's a low elite, who is leading their squad right now. He's rated as a depth forward, 23 years old, 78 overall. Montreal is a team, don't have very many high overall players. They look a little weak on that squad right there. Jonathan Drouin is an 89, though, so he definitely helps it out. Let's go in the system. Do they have anybody to come up? Gorin and Kiprasov, the only two guys, neither of them are ready to play. We'll see. Let's win the way they drafted. Undrafted, so he was picked up, Gary Gorin. And then Timo Kiprasov, 2022 fifth round. So both guys taken late. It's good to see. Montreal, let's go to Nashville. Rasmus Dahlin, he is a stud out of his mind. Taken in the first round, number one overall pick. Rated as a top two guy, 89 overall, medium elite. Still has like 3 years to develop, I believe. So that's pretty good to see. In the system, they have two low elites, both 69 overall, both 19 years old. Let's see when they were taken. Fourth round. I believe this guy, I thought this guy was the guy we dropped because I released a guy named Claussen as well. So, but this guy was drafted by them. Fourth round, third round of 2022. So they have a nice little draft class ready to come up there. Let's go to the next team, the New Jersey Devils. They've had a couple guys. High elite Rick Hall here. First round, number one overall pick, 18 years old, already 81. Overall, so this guy might have a big year. Luke Gallardi, 88 overall, medium elite, taken in 2021 with the third pick. These guys got to get good soon. They can't keep getting all these picks. And then Nico Hischier, he's developed. He's actually one of the lower forwards on their team now. He needs to develop a little bit better. Let's go in the system, see what they have. They have two more low elites, Ross Graham and Harry Landry. Harry Landry is first round pick, fifth overall. Ross Graham, these guys look like they need to start developing now. Get them good. X-Ray, I saw this name and I love it. I wish I had him on my team. Might have to make a trade for him. Hopefully he gets good. Low top six guy, X-Ray. I believe it's Xavier Ray, yeah, but what a nickname for that guy there. Main roster, let's go down to the next team, the New York Islanders. Matthew Barzal looking pretty good. DeBrincat, I learned how to say his name, guys. I said it right in the last video. I've been saying it DeBrincat, and I know that's wrong until I said it. Before I knew how to say his name, I forgot for a brief period. Remembered again, Alex DeBrincat. Let's go in the system. Nobody really here. They have an ex-Morrow, Xavier Morrow, who looks like he might be ready to crack the NHL in maybe a year. Back to the main roster. Let's go to the Rangers. Who do they got? Lieb and Stasiak. 85, Earl Lieb and Anthony Stasiak. Both guys taken in the first round. Both guys looking like they are going to be good players in the future. We'll see how they develop going on. These guys also drafted first round. First round, okay, so they've been drafting well. Got a couple good guys there. Let's go in the system. Lundmark, he was taken in the third round, 2022, so nice pick there. Medium elite, Lance Lundmark. We'll see how he develops in the future. Back to the main roster. Let's go check Ottawa. Thomas Chabot, we just picked him up, so hopefully he keeps developing like this in our other GM mode. He's an 87 overall defenseman, low elite, so he's developed well. That's good to see. Carlson's still a stud. They have a couple top six guys here. Let's see, Bruce Almond, okay, Colin White as well, first round picks, and then Logan Brown, obviously. So let's go in the system. Do they have anybody else? No, nobody else really there. They have this high top nine forward, Alex Fermentin, 74 overall, taking the second round. 2017. All right, let's go back to the main roster, down to the Flyers. Oh, man, they are stacked with some medium elites there. They might be getting good here pretty soon. Adrian Bancroft taking the first round. He is 83 overall. He still has time to develop. Donald Jung, remember when this guy got drafted? I like the name. First round, fourth overall in 2020, medium elite 21. Nolan Patrick struggling to develop a little bit there, not as good as Hishie. And then other guys who have been drafted after him have been developing a little faster. So I wonder what's going on there. Provorov is an 88 as well. And then they have Kenny Black, who got taken in 2018, fifth round pick. He is developing nicely, 23 years old, 82 overall. So that's a good pick there. In the system, they have one guy, Sammy Tominen. Low elite, 78 overall, taken in the sixth round 2019. So they are developing these young guys well, 22 years old. Hopefully my guys can get there soon. Let's go check the Pittsburgh Penguins. Not a lot in terms of prospects there. Let's go check in the system. Yeah, not a lot there either. So they better start stacking up or they're going to start to struggle here soon. Sorry about that. Jet Wu. What a name. Sounds like an Asian action film star. Jet Wu. I'd love for him to be on the actual Pittsburgh Penguins. He scores a goal. Everybody in the crowd goes, woo! That'd be pretty fun. Let's go and check the system. Do they have anybody here? No, they do not. So they might be struggling in a couple years if they can't grab somebody good. Let's go see Jacob McAllister, 77 overall, taken in the most recent draft. Looking pretty good. Alexander Plankinov, 23 years old, 84 overall for a low elite, so he's developed nicely. And then he has him there. Let's go in the system. Nothing really crazy there. They have one low elite who they just picked up, actually. Patrick Eberle, left wing grinder, undrafted, so they picked him up as a free agent. Let's go back to the main roster. St. Louis Guerrero, low elite, so another guy who's been developing well, fourth round pick, 81 overall, so that's good to see. We're seeing some low elite guys develop. Medium elite guy here, Toby Streit, who they drafted in late round in the first in this most recent draft. Player there. Let's go to the next team, Tampa Bay. Mikhail Sergachev. He has been developing nicely. 25 years old. He is medium elite. Probably one more year to develop. One or two more years maybe. He's 86, so we'll see if he gets any better than that. Let's go in the system, see who they got. Cal Foot. Wow. Callen Foot, okay, let's see, 2017 draft, wow, he has not developed at all, so I wonder if there's something going on. Wait, is that his, like, brother, because wasn't there a Cal Foot? Am I going crazy? Callen Foot, and then there's a Cal Foot, or is this the same guy? Because my guy's been developing nicely, when this guy, he looks like he's been struggling a little bit, 14th overall pick, jeez. And then they have this guy, Peter, fuck these names, Tupkin, 75 overall, low elite, 22 years old. He's a nice pick there. Next, we have Roger Garcia, undrafted guy. So we really got to start sorting. I've been missing these undrafted guys in free agency. And then that guy there. So that's the end of their elites. Let's go to the next team, the Toronto Maple Leafs, Kulishov, 84 overall, first round pick, 16th overall. Wow, so nice pick there by Toronto. There you go. Okay, Mitchell Marner, he's been developing nicely, 89 overall. Tim Zancanaro. So this is a guy we could have had if the computer didn't sign me Austin Matthews. We could have had this guy right here, 87 overall. I'd much rather had this guy. And then Timothy Liljegren, low elite. He's really struggling to develop there. So these low elite guys really have an uphill battle with development. There's our boy, Jesus Creamer, one of the best names we've had, and a great size, 5'9", 182. He's out there creaming them on the ice in the AHL or in minors. And then we have Clint Nash taken in 2020, so he's developing nicely, 21 years old. We really got to learn. I got to learn how to develop these guys because I've been playing my team, and we'll see when we get to it. But I've been playing my guys in the minors, and they stink. My minor league team is terrible. And, wow, Jake Gensel there over with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Wow. But, yeah, I'm just disappointed we couldn't get this guy. But, yeah, my guys haven't been developing, and we'll see it when we get to my team. Vancouver Canucks, I believe we're next. Here he is, the stud of the draft classes that has been here. The only high franchise guy we have seen come out, Bryce Baumgartner, taken 2020 draft, first overall. He is a 94 overall. He has 5 stars in every category, 4.5 in physical, but he's almost there. Very good, just the fighting skill is holding him back. But this guy is a stud. Let's go look at what he's been doing, his full career stats. We can see his first year in the NHL draft, in the NHL was 2020. He really had a good year. Wow, 96 points in 2021-2022 with a plus 43 rating. That's whenever I think they went to the Stanley Cup Finals or at least finished first overall. So he's been a big part of that. He's got a $10 million contract, so much deserved there for Bryce Bumgarner. Olli Juolevi, 87 overall. He's turned into a good player as well. Elias Pettersson, first-round pick in 2017, is developing. Ian Weller, second-round pick there, medium elite, so he looks pretty good. And then they have another guy, Ross McDonald, taking 2022 fourth round. So it looks really random with these low elite guys who's developing. But it looks like, I mean, it might just, I don't know if it, what it is, but these defensive defensemen, this is what, the third or fourth one we've seen now who's been taken later in a draft other than like the top five and has developed pretty well. So maybe that has something to do with it. So guys, maybe take a look at that, draft some of these defensive defensemen and see how they do that are low elites. Let's go to the next team, and it is our Vegas Golden Knights. You can see we're stacked with our elites here. We have Austin Matthews, who's been playing very well for us. He has a big, big contract, $11 million. Let's see, 92 overall, so he's been doing really well, five stars in most categories. Raymond Martinez, who we drafted in 2022, has been developing a little bit nicely. He's 80 overall right now. He's on our second line, I believe, for defenseman. Sheldon Saric, who we drafted 30th. 79 overall. Wish he would develop a little bit more, but he has been struggling a little bit. Bjorkstrand, low elite offensive defenseman there. Toby Coe, he's been struggling a little bit to develop as well. Craig LaRose, he's been developing well as a low elite guy we took in 2019. And then we have Scrivens, another guy who's been developing, low elite guy. So we'll see what he's able to do. And Weeman. And we signed Mika Zibanejad as well. So we got a lot of low elites there. And then let's look at even more in the system. We are stacked. But as you can see, these guys only, this guy we picked up is a medium elite in the free agents market this year. So that was pretty cool. Benjamin Kwong, defensive defenseman. So we'll follow him, see if he develops. He's already 20 years old, so maybe he's a little bit behind the curve. And then Jacob Crombean, who we drafted in the second round in 2022. We'll see if they can develop. And then you can see all these guys here, low elites. I've been playing them too, guys. So, I mean, I don't know what to do, but these guys aren't developing. So it's pretty disappointing, but, you know, it's live and learn. We're going to just see what these guys can become. They're all still pretty young, too. We'll wait till they get around 22, 23, and then we'll really start to judge if they're going to be a lost cause or not. Back to the main roster. We have the Washington Capitals. No real elites to speak of prospects there. Anybody here? Not really. They got some low top six guys and some top nine guys starting to develop there, but nothing besides that. Let's go back to the main roster. Last team, the Winnipeg Jets. Two medium elite guys. One is Patrick Laine. Terry James, drafted 2021, first overall medium elite, 83 overall now. Patrick Laine is developing nicely. He's a 90 overall. And they have these two guys here. Kyle Connor, 2015, and that guy, 2015 as well. Let's go in the system, see if they have any. Hey, there's our other boy, Earl Lee, defensive defenseman, 20 years old. He's taken a 2022 in the third round. So let's see. We'll see if he starts to develop as well, one of those other defensive defensemen. Stanislav Alexandrov, 19 years old, seventh round pick, 199th pick. Wow. So hopefully he develops. That'd be a cool player to talk about. Let's go. Is that it? Yep. Let's go to goalies now. See who's there. Medium elite guy right here in Dmitry Zaykov, taken in 2018, the 22nd pick. You can see he's developing nicely. One of the few guys, I think, who's actually been developing. This is what their prospects look like. Let's go to the next video. Next one. Next video. High elite guy there. Wow. Jesus Davis, 23 years old, taken in the first year draft, 19th pick. High elite. Wow. 92 overall. Now that guy's a stud. Let's see how he's been doing his statistics. 38-22 record last season, so you'd hope for a little bit better than that, but he's obviously young and getting a lot better. And then they have Antti Raanta backing him up. That's what their prospects look like. Down to Boston, still Tuukka Rask in net. No elites there. Let's go back to the next team. Buffalo, Luukkonen there. Medium elite, Ukko, Pekka, Luukkonen. Lots of Ks in his name. The Quad K Man. Oh, actually, that's more in quest. Whatever the six is. Six tuplet? let's go. There we go. Ukko, Pekka, Luukkonen, 24 years old, medium elite, 84 overall. Let's go in the system. They have anybody else? No. No elites there. Down to Calgary. Parsons, 79. So they're starting to struggle with goalies there. They need a couple of these guys to start developing. Carolina, Scott Darling still in net for them. They have a starter goalie who needs to develop there. Down to Chicago, Ramon Lehner. Corey Crawford's really stinking it up. High backup potential there, guys, so that guy should go pretty quickly. 26 years old, though, so yeah, he's almost done. Back to the main roster, Colorado, Darcy Kemper in net. Dansk, they have this guy who they took in 2022, Mats Dansk, 67 overall, so he needs to develop quickly because their goaltending situation is tough. Blackwood and Corpusalo there, so Corpusalo's developed nicely. He's 29 years old now. No elites in the system. Dallas Stars, Malcolm Subban and Ben Bishop still there. 36 years old. He's holding on to his potential very, or his overall very well for being 36, still an 88. That's not bad. Not bad at all. Let's go. We're clicking every button but the one I need. Let's see if they've had any starting to stumble on the words. This video is getting too long. Detroit Red Wings, Gravel and Sergeyev. Sergey Sergeyev, there we go, 81 overall, medium starter, so he's been developing, and then so both taken in the 2018 draft, one after the other, Alexis Gravel. In the system, they have this Yostefson, who's 76 overall, might be ready in a year or two. Back to the main roster, down to the Oilers, though this is the only thing that could maybe hold them back from a Stanley Cup, is they have no goalies. Stuart Skinner, disappointing for us in our other GM mode if he develops like that. Let's go there. So there we go. Nothing really special there that could hold them back from a Stanley Cup. Goaltending situation here as well, struggling. Oda here. They have Matthew Oda, medium elite. He needs to develop. 2022. They took him in the second round. That's a very nice pick. They have a couple starters there who aren't developing very well. Los Angeles Kings. Jonathan Quick's really shit in the bed. He's not very good anymore. Laurent Gauthier, undrafted goalie, medium elite. Wow. So that's not a very bad pickup right there. Definitely make sure you guys sort every single offseason for those free agents. Devin Dubnyk's been dropping off. He's now a fringe starter. Wow. And then no goalies in the system who are developing. Carey Price, 88 overall, so he looks pretty good in the system. Nobody that's developing. They have this guy right here, undrafted goalie Michael McNevin, 26 years old now. Let's go back to the main roster. Nashville, Hansen, and Soros. Looks like Pekarene is no longer there. And they only have one goalie in the system, and he's not developing either, so goaltending problems there. All right, here we go with New Jersey. Steve Mason and Domingue, both not special. Okay, there we go. Richards, so they have a guy who, so it looks like watch out for New Jersey in the next couple of years. Took him in the first round. He's 78 overall, now medium elite. Hopefully he develops soon. The Islanders. Bobrovsky's there, so is Soderstrom, not a bad pick. And then they have this guy, Brent Schoten, second round. Where's he from? Germany. Yeah, perfect name, Schoten. I guess it sounds there. I don't know. Second round pick, medium elite, 19 years old, 67 overall. And then they have another guy, Patrick Wallin, 2021 draft, second round. Both taken in the second round. Yeah, they were. Okay, cool. Both guys need to start developing. We've been seeing a lot of goalies struggle to develop, I feel like, in these games. At least this year. They're medium elite here. Stuart Lessard, 2023, taken in the first round, so hopefully he can develop there. Down to Ottawa. Nobody there. They have a lot of goalies in the system. They have a starter here who they took in the 2019 draft, Cameron Blacker. 22 years old, 81 overall. Hopefully some of these other guys start to develop, maybe some trading assets for them in the future. Philadelphia, Carter Hart, I believe, 83 overall, low elite. He's got one or two more years to develop in the system. Nobody really there. Low elite there for Carter Hart. Matt Murray, 90 overall. Tristan Jarry developed into a decent goalie, a decent backup, 82 overall. In the system, nobody really developing there. Let's go down to San Jose. Martin Jones still holding the net. Voinov here looking to come up. And then they have Cody Hope, who they took in 22, the fifth round. Wow, nice pick. Hopefully he develops. Yuri Voinov taken in the second round, 2020. 78 overall, so hopefully he'll be ready to go in a year or two. And then they have a high backup who they took, 2018. Okay, so that's not a bad pick. So they'll be hopefully shoveling off some of those goalies to teams in need. Evan Fitzpatrick here, medium starter, 25 years old, 83, not bad. In the system, medium elite here, we have Brendan Reagan, undrafted. Wow, another guy, so definitely look through those free agents and sort for those elite potentials. Vasilevskiy there, 90 overall, and then they have a low starter here, Connor Ingram, who is 81, Coburn, and Paco, there, who they're hoping to develop. Toronto Maple Leafs, again, Frederick Anderson still in net, and Dice DeSalvatore. Yeah, there we go. All right, next team, let's go Vancouver Canucks. Demko developed into a 90 overall. Thatcher Demko, very good goalie there. In the system here, we have Vermette, who they have as a prospect. 2022 seventh round medium elite goalie. Wow. That's pretty cool. Let's go to our Vegas Golden Knights. We signed Peter Mrazek, and we have Calvin Picard in net. Let's go in the system. We still have Kanenis, Vikingstad, and Young. And then we have Aalto, who's developing as well, 77 overall. So he's looking pretty good. Might be ready in a year or two. But this is the guy we really hope to develop. Grabbed him in the fourth round. He was projected to go undrafted, listed as a high franchise guy when we drafted him, turned medium franchise. 21 years old, though, so he is getting a bit older. So we're hoping for a big jump after this season. I have him starting in the I have him as a backup in the AHL, so we'll see how he does there. And the final team, well, we actually have Washington. Braden Holtby still holding the fourth there. They have two elite goaltenders. Tom Pitton, who's taken in 2020, who's developing. And then they have, go to the next one, Hendrik Fast, first round 2021, late first round guy. So we'll see. A lot of these guys, they're getting right around that age where they need to start developing. So we'll see if we get anybody with a big jump anytime soon, and nobody here at Winnipeg. And I believe that is it. Yeah, that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. If there was anything I missed here, wow. Anaheim needs to offload one of these guys. Jesus. But yeah, let me know if there's anybody I missed. What do you guys think about the development so far? I know, especially with our team, a lot of the guys are still young, so we have to wait maybe a year or two to see how they develop. But other than that, you know, it's been pretty disappointing what I've seen so far. I'll sim through the season after this, and we'll get another draft video up soon. But thanks for watching, guys. This is where all these players are now. Hopefully some of them start to develop. But that's going to be it for this video. Peace.